Regex is simply the short form for regular expression. It allows you to perform repetitive tasks automatically using pattern matching within text. For example, if you wish to redirect one URL to another, you can manually set up each redirection. But what if you have hundreds of URLs to redirect? Manually creating hundreds of redirects can lead to link management problems, and you may miss some redirects. So Regex allows you to create a set of conditions for redirection. For example, you can set a rule to redirect any URL containing blog to a new URL without that parameter using a pattern like this. And all URLs matching this pattern will be redirected accordingly. I know it sounds a little complicated, but by the end of this video, I'm pretty sure you'll be confident with using Regex to redirect your URLs. This is especially helpful if you wish to change the URL structure of your site. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides you with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. All right, let's first talk about what tool you will need to do Regex redirects on WordPress. You need RankMath. Not because we are RankMath, but because most other SEO plugins charge a fee to unlock that feature. And also, you don't need to add single use or single feature plugins that may bloat your site. When you have RankMath installed on your site, if you hover over RankMath SEO, you should be able to see the redirections module here. But if you don't see this, it means you have not turned the module on. So what you want to do is to go to the dashboard, scroll down till you see the redirections module right here, and you want to make sure to toggle this on. And as soon as you have done that, you will see the redirections module here. Let's visit the module, and here's where you can manage all your redirections. To create a redirection, you want to click on Add New. And over here, you will see that RankMath provides you with a wide range of options to create a redirect or group of redirects. But our main focus is on the Regex option. Before we continue, we recommend that you check out this page on Wikipedia to understand the common characters in Regex. But don't worry, we will explain it as I walk you through some examples. For a Regex redirection to work, there are two steps. Step 1 is to define the pattern in the URL you're looking for, and only if the pattern is found in the URL, that URL will be put to the next step, which is the redirection.
You see, this is a typical redirection where you will specify a specific URL, and this URL will be redirected to your specified destination URL. However, for Regex redirection, let's say that you're looking for a pattern in the URL where there is a first part in the URL and then there is a second part in the URL, and they will be redirected with the second part of the URL, which will make it look like this. So for the Regex source URL, it will look something like this, where this is to select the first part of the URL and this is to select the second part of the URL. Don't worry, I'll talk about them in a while. I just want to show you how Regex works. So basically, you will not define a specific URL because you want RankMath to look for a pattern in your URL. And you won't specify a specific destination URL as well, because you won't want all the source URL that meet the condition to be redirected to just one page. You want them to redirect with the second part of the URL that replaces the first part. So the destination URL will look something like this, where you are calling the second part to be added here. Or in other words, it will look like this. It is the same meaning as this. So if I want to make all the redirections a 301 permanent move, and as I create the redirection, check this out. This is the URL before the redirection, and if we want to remove this part of the URL, we need to make sure that the destination URL is a page that exists. So in this case, since we have created that redirection, but the destination URL is not an active page, as I refresh it, you can see that this is the destination URL we want, but this page is not live, it's not active. So before you make any redirections, you gotta make sure that the destination URL is an active page, a page that can be found on your site.
So now let me share with you some common examples.
Now in WordPress, if you have made changes in the permalink settings of your site, for example, currently it is using the custom structure with the category right before the post name, which looks like this, where this is the category and this is the post name. Now, if we decide to change this custom structure to this post name structure instead, the URLs will be redirected automatically. So if we save changes and we refresh this page, take note of the URL here. If I click on refresh, the URL will be redirected from the URL with the category to just the post name. Now this is great, but the problem comes when you want to amend the custom structure. So for example, all the URLs on my site contains this .html extension, but now I decide to remove this .html extension and just have the post name here. As I save changes, and if I click on refresh, the page will not be redirected. Check this out. It becomes a 404 page, which means a page that could not be found on your site. So any link juice or SEO benefits that were accumulated for this link would have been lost if nothing else is done. And if this is not a one-time occurrence, but it happens to all your other URLs, it would have been disastrous. So with the help of a Regex redirection, this problem will be solved easily. So currently this URL leads you to a 404 page. If we visit RankMath's redirections module, let's add a new redirection and choose the regex option. We want to add something like this, where this set of symbols mean capture everything before the .html extension. In layman terms, whatever that RankMath can find before the .html extension will meet the condition for the regex redirection. And then in regex language, the period or dot by itself is an operator or special character. Just like this, the dot or period has a special purpose. But in this context, the dot is not an operator. It is part of the HTML extension. So to tell RankMath that this period or dot is not an operator, we need to add this backslash right in front of the dot. And then after that, if RankMath can find any URLs that contain this .html extension, they will meet the regex redirection condition. So any URLs that matches this pattern will be redirected. But to where? If you add $1 to the destination URL, which means the same thing as this, it means that whatever captured in the first parenthesis, in this case it is a string of text or the URL slug, will be added right after the domain. So if, for example, your URLs have two sets of text to fit the regex redirection condition, if you want to use the second group of text captured within the parentheses, you would add $2 to the destination URL. If you want to use the text of the first group, then you will use $1. So in this case, there is just one group, and that's why we have $1. So we want all the redirection to be in 301, which means all the redirections are permanent. And let's create the redirection. If we visit the URL again with the .html extension, if we refresh the page, it will be redirected to the URL with just the post name. I hope this is easy for you to understand. Now, if you want to learn more about the differences between 301, 302, or 307 redirects, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, let's say that you have a date-based URL structure, and in your site's permalink settings, you wish to change it to a clean post URL. And as we save changes and refresh this page, you will see that it leads us to a 404 error. And to solve this problem, let's visit RankMath's redirection module and create a new redirection. Remember to change this to the regex option. And now you want to add a regex rule like this in your source URL, where in the first set of numbers, you are looking for 4 digits, because this set of characters will look for 4 digits in your URL. And then in your second set of numbers, you are looking for 2 digits, which is right here. And the same goes for the third set of numbers. So whether this be 12, 13, 0, 7, 0, 8, they will all be selected. And after the numbers, you will want all the URL slugs after the set of dates to meet the regex condition and pattern. And since this is the only parenthesis group, the destination URL will be $1. If we create the redirection, go to the URL again, take note of the URL as I refresh the page, and now it will be redirected to the clean post URL.
To be honest, there is no way that I can cover every single regex use case because your URL patterns may be different from mine and you may need some customized solutions. So let me share with you a way to solve your regex redirections on your own. Believe it or not, Content AI can help solve your problems.
On your dashboard, hover over RankMath SEO and select the Content AI module. And then click on the chat feature. And now you can ask RankBot about your regex redirection. I have already described my issue with RankBot, where I said, I'm trying to create a regex redirection. And here are my old URLs. There are two sets of URLs, one with the S and one without. and I want them to be redirected to these clean URLs. And RankBot responded with the following. This is the regex pattern, and this will be added to the destination URL field. And it explained that this regex redirect will match both URLs with recipe and recipes and capture the remaining part of the URL. Now the thing is, the answers from RankBot are a good start to creating your custom regex, but it may not be 100% correct. So you need to check this regex against another tool we recommend called regex101.com. This tool will help you test and debug the regex. So let's copy the regex from RankBot and paste it here. And as you can see, there's two issues being flagged. The issue is an unescape delimiter must be escaped. And remember the backslash? It will tell RankMath that this slash is not an operator. So you would add a backslash right in front of the slash and do the same for the other, and it would solve the problems. And this symbol symbolizes the start of the regex. This is cool because it explains every single regex character. So for the start of the regex, we don't actually need it, so we can remove it. The same goes for the dollar sign at the back that symbolizes the end of the regex, so we can remove it. Now in RankMath, we don't need to start with the slash, so you can remove these characters. And this will be the final regex to add to the source URL. So let's copy this, let's create a new redirection, and paste it in the source URL field. Change this to regex, and as you can see, there are two groups of parentheses, and we want the second group to be added to the destination URL. So we will add slash $2. And if we add the redirection, all these old URLs will be redirected to the new URLs. Now we recommend that after creating regex redirects, you want to monitor your 404 links and then debug them. So on your RankMath's dashboard, you want to make sure to toggle this 404 monitor module on and take note of any URLs that appear here. That way you will know if your regex redirection is working for other URLs on your site. And then you also want to turn on the redirect debugger too by visiting the general settings and redirections. Here you want to turn on the debug redirections option and save changes. What this does is if a URL is being redirected, login users like yourself, you will see something like this, where it will tell you where this URL is being redirected to. Your site visitors will not see this, so you don't have to worry about that. And if there is an error on the destination URL, such as it is leading you to a 404 error, you want to figure out which redirection entry is causing the error by clicking on this, and it will bring you to the redirection entry. And from here, you can fix the redirection, assuming that this is the cause. So with this, I hope you are confident with using regex redirects. If you have any questions at all, feel free to leave a comment down below and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to us, do so because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.